Okay, number seven. Number seven is to have a training partner. So different than being part of a community, but having like a training partner, if you're able to, it could be virtually, it could be in person. You know, some of the best, well, probably the best training of my life is when I had a training partner. And largely that was during the time I trained with Vanessa Espinosa. And that, you know, it just, there's just something about not just someone to hold you accountable or, you know, all those important things, but someone to push you, you know, while you're there in the moment, someone to enjoy the experience with, someone to have fun with. I know this is a little bit different during this era that we're in of COVID pandemic and all this kind of stuff. And it could still be, you know, a virtual experience in that way, where maybe you still go, you go to the gym at the same time and, you know, recap each other afterwards, or, you know, you make, or at least you go on the same day, even if it's not the same time, and you kind of share your workouts, your highlights, that kind of stuff. But once we do get back to you know, more regular type of lifestyle, I think having a training partner in the gym, a running buddy, a climbing buddy, a, you know, cycling.
Yeah, I miss that. Yeah.
Is really, really important. Because oftentimes what I find, I don't know what your experience is, Richard, but when I go to the gym, and gyms are open where I live in Colorado, there's, you know, lots of restrictions, of course, which you know, I've been following for a whole year of the temperature checks and the mask wearing, the spray bottles and the distancing equipment and all that.
But same way here. Yeah.
Yeah. But what I still find, and I find it fascinating, and partly I find it fascinating because I've been this person, is that a lot of people are, you know, training by themselves, but they spend pretty much an equal amount of time on their phone as they do doing the exercises.
Yes.
And I've been around long enough to know they're not just like changing the song on their phone, or they're not just like documenting their workout. They're like, some people will literally, and I watch them, and I'm just, because, you know, I'm on.
I've seen it too. Yep.
Where they may actually spend 20 minutes, and you can see they're doing like this. They're just scrolling, because there's the temptation is so strong. The internet, social media, notifications is so strong that I will see people, or I might complete 8 sets, you know, maybe we have different goals, who knows what the case is, but in a period where I do 8 sets, they might do 1. And while they, you know, they're going to hog equipment for 20, I mean, sometimes literally 20, 25 minutes without doing anything. And then they finally put the phone down and do their exercise. And the moment, I'm talking the moment they put the weight down, they grab the phone and they're back at it again.
I've seen that all the time, yeah.
And I feel like if you have a training partner, you probably wouldn't do that. You're like, because while your training partner is, you know, is training, you're resting, and you switch. Like you just get back
exactly on
the machine or the weights or whatever, or you're talking in between, but you're not going to talk for 20 minutes in between. You're going to be, you know, catching your breath and saying, if you make a small talk, then okay, let's go again. Let's go. You know, you're
exactly, yeah.
And so I think I see that all the time. And again, some people are there, that is their victory, just to get in the gym. And if they get only a few sets in because they're distracted by their phone, or they're watching videos, or they're texting for half an hour, maybe they claim that as a victory because they've made it into the gym. But what I think we all want, because for going to the gym in the first place, or doing whatever kind of exercise it is we want some sort of results. And I just don't think you're gonna get those results if you're distracted. And some people just don't have the discipline. And so what I've done, actually it started because of the germs and everything. It started because of COVID, you know, just worry whether those are warranted or not, depending on how, you know, those types of germs spread. I just left my phone in the car. I never brought it into the gym, and I still haven't for a full year. And I've had some really great progress and some great workouts because it's not, I can't get distracted if I want to, it's not there. And I don't, you know, have anybody to talk to at the gym. And so I'm focused. And, you know, if I had a training partner, I think I could even push harder, or I could have a spotter and lift heavier weights and all these things. But because I don't, I do go solo. I leave the phone away and I just maintain focus. And I've had some of my best workouts and most progress that I've made in a long time. Maybe on the odd occasion I'm there for 2 hours straight, but it's just, you know, I'll just get back to my phone when I get back to it. You know, whatever I miss, I miss. If you do have a trading partner, they can help keep you a little bit disciplined and a little bit organized, and you're both, you know, because then you're on that person's time too. You know, you can't just, you know, waste your own time, but you got to make sure you value someone else's time too. And you're there together. And so I think a training partner can be incredibly valuable and help you push heavier weights by being a spotter and all those kinds of things. But if you don't have the opportunity to have a training partner now, you can still have some sort of virtual accountability where even if you share your workouts online for people to read or something, and then and if you are going solo, just to try to be, you know, as focused and disciplined as possible, because you're there for a reason. And typically that reason is for results, and you've got to put in the work to get those results.